that would be small.
I'm sorry.
Kevin says we need to find a new restaurant.
Prince Charles.
And Prince Charles. Like, this woman that he has.
Paul.
What's her name? Her Duchess of Cornwall or something.
Paul.
Yeah. Camille.
Good evening and welcome to the Renaissance. We have a few notes for the evening. Our playbills are accessible through the QR codes that are posted in the lobby and around the theater. Our playbills include all of our cast pictures, their bios, and a show synopsis. Please remember, no flash photography during the show. We will have one 15-minute intermission. During that intermission, please help yourself to some concessions and Fanagrams in the lobby. Both of those are for sale. Fanagrams are notes that you can purchase to send to cast and crew members. Also, we have a Something Rotten photo booth set up with some props for your enjoyment. If you would tag those, hashtag ASTG, we would appreciate it. Also, please remember to silence your phones. At this time, Academy Street Theater Group, an arts and education program of the Cherokee County School District, is proud to present Something Rotten.
Thank you. wants. It's so frustrating, cause if you're William Shakespeare, you're hotter than hot. But if you're any other writer, then you're not. Oh, noble kinsmen, that royal blood and love do bind, seek thy own succor and flee thy native lands. To die today, 'twill not be done till dawn, to tea, to tum, to tea, to tum. And oh, who talks like this? Nigel, why can't we just write like we speak?
Yeah, I haven't understood a single word in our last three plays.
Did I miss my cue? Robin, what are you wearing? This isn't dress rehearsal.
I thought it would help me, you know, get into character if I were to wear dresses and hang out in taverns and flirt with men. for research.
Right.
Nick, I have a question about motivation.
Yes?
Why haven't you given up yet?
Peter! This one is working out, okay? I can feel it. It's just missing something right here. Nigel, help me out.
I did write something in my notebook last night. I was thinking it might be good if King Richard was contemplating his own mortality. But now that I've said it out loud, it sounds stupid.
Well, let me read it.
It's probably
just terrible. Let me see it.
Oh God, it's bad, isn't it? I don't even know why you let me write with you.
Nigel, it's good.
Yeah?
It's really good.
Well, I put a lot of layers in it.
Just one suggestion. How about here instead of tombs, he says epitaphs?
Ooh, that's better. Good one, brother.
Okay, everyone, let's try this. Let us talk of graves, of worms, of epitaphs. Make dust our paper, and with rainy eyes write sorrow on the bosom of the earth. Yes, that's good. I believe this might be the Bottom Brothers' first big hit.
Well, then it's a pity we have to shut it down.
Lord Claflin, what do you mean shut it down?
Well, guess whose next play is the tragedy of Richard II?
Shakespeare? Well, why is he doing Richard II? He just did Richard III! Who goes backwards?
He breaks convention. That's why he's so great.
Great? Did you see Romeo and Juliet? What's so great about two lovers who killed themselves at the end?
No, no, no! You've spoiled it. I was supposed to see it this evening.
You should. It's life-changing.
Is it? Love you. Stab myself. Drink poison.
No, 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 no! You've ruined everything. Now, I paid for an original production, and I will get it. You hear? No more money unless I get a new idea on the morrow.
Lord Clapham, please!
Write something original. Like the Bard.
Bard? Why is he the Bard? He's a Bard. Just like I'm a Bard, you're a Bard. He's just one of the Bards.
He's the Bard because he does it all. Histories, tragedies, comedies.
Comedies? Okay, then name one line of his that's funny. One, anything.
On my word, we'll not curry coals, for then we shall be colliers!
That's not funny! Oh God, I hate Shakespeare! That's right, I said it! I hate Shakespeare! I just don't get it, how a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the proudest jewel in England's royal crown! Oh God, I hate Shakespeare! These plays are wordy, but oh no, the great Shakespeare! That little turd, he has no sense about the audience. You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the Bard who's such a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a man?
He's a hack with a knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that? A man really knows how to write a pitch and play. You wish you could have one.
I just wish that he would go away.
Greatest. it again tomorrow, okay? Just come back and we'll have a new idea for you tomorrow. We need a new idea.
I still say we should write our life story. Two orphan brothers, their father lost at sea, whose mother died of a broken heart. How you, at age 14, carried me, your sickly little brother, on your back, all the way from Cornwall.
No, we need to think bigger. We need to innovate. The whole world is changing. I recently heard about a man who has a toilet that flushes.
He doesn't throw his crap onto the street?
No! He pulls his big lever and it goes down his pipe and then into the street. But that's what we need, something new.
That's what you're good at. Big ideas. I'm just a poet at heart. You were doing better without me. God, am I the problem?
No, you're not the problem, Nigel. Shakespeare is. Why did I ever suggest he become a writer? I was just trying to get him out of our troupe because he was so annoying, and now he's like this giant sun that
shines so bright no other star is seen.
See? That's why we work well together. Now let's get to it.
Okay.
Ah, Nicholas Botto.
Shylock, what are you doing at my house?
Your debt is due.
Shh. Right, I've had a little setback with the play, all right? If you just give me another week, I'll name a character after you.
Do it. Shakespeare already promised that one. Oh, I can see it now. Shylock, a really nice Jew. Here, I'll make you a better offer. You cut me in as an investor in your play, and I'll cancel your debt.
Well, you're not a patron, you're a money lender.
Because that's the only job that they'll let me do. Oh, but what I really love, what gives me knocks in my puppet, is the theater. Oh, I love it, I love it, I love it. I love the sights, I love the smells, I love the roar of the crowd, the splat of the fruit as it hits the actors. It's a temple to me, I tell ya. A temple, Catholic, Protestant, Jew. I don't give a rat's chuckus. My religion is the theater.
Wow, I had no idea. But, you know, it's illegal. If I hired you, we'd both be hanged at Tyburn.
At least you'd finally have an audience. Here, take the weekend. Pull it over, because on Monday, you're at your stumps.
Oh, hello, darling. How was your day?
Interesting. I went down to the stocks and watched the mob throw cabbages at criminals.
What'd you do that for? You hate all of that.
I know, it was awful. Boiled cabbage.
I see. I think it's delicious.
Oh, thanks, Nigel. Well, there would have been meat, but our landlord came by demanding the rent, took our last shilling right out of my hand. Then, he was going to prepare you some mutton, but sheep are fast.
Wait. You chased a sheep. All right, that's it.
What are you doing?
I'm just,
No, no! We have been through this. We do not touch the money box.
But, B, we don't have to live like this. You deserve better.
And so do you. We all do. That's what we're saving up for. A better life. A simple cottage out in the country. You, me, a couple kids. Maybe a room for Nigel and a wife one day.
Oh, stop it.
Now, I know it's been a while since we've actually put anything in there, but that's why I was thinking maybe I should get a job.
Wait, what? No, you can't get a job. That'll just make me feel like a failure. None of the other writers' wives have jobs.
Well, they should. I mean, this is the 90s. We have a woman on the throne, and by the year 1600, women will be completely equal to men. I just had the perfect idea! I could be in your play!
What? You can't act? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Gotcha, see, I can act.
Well, B, it's illegal to put women on stage.
And anyway, our play's been canceled.
What?
Not canceled, Knives. It's such a negative way to put it. Well, yes, we're no longer doing Richard II, but that's only because we've come up with a better idea.
No! Well, what is that better idea?
Can't say. Don't want to jinx it.
Oh, so there is no idea.
Well, we've had the idea that,
we need an idea.
Then let me help you. I'll go out, earn some money, and take some stress off of you guys.
B, listen.
No, you listen. I just want to make things better. And I need you to understand that. If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you like, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick, helping you whenever I can. I'm more than just a woman, baby. When the pressure's coming, baby, let me be your right hand man.
But you're not a man. I'm the man.
You're not listening to me. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me and crickle behind the cast iron.
I'm not the pickle.
You and me should be a team for any dream or any scheme. That's how it should be done. Sure, I can stay in the club.
God, I hate Shakespeare, but when I sit and really contemplate Shakespeare, I guess I hate the fact that he is everything I ever dreamed that I could be. I mostly hate the way he makes me feel about me. 'Cause the truth is, it wouldn't be that bad to be Shakespeare. In fact, I'd give my left arm to be Shakespeare if I could only have one tiny little smidgen of his notoriety. It would relieve
relieve me of the pressures of responsibility. I gotta make it happen, gotta find that pot of gold. If there was just some way to know just what the future holds. What the future holds! Unforeseen circumstances. Well, obviously not the very best.
Did I hear a need for future seeing? If seeing is what you need, I can help you. If help is what you need, I can see you. If neither is what you need, well, then I foresee you leaving very shortly. Oh, so, do I have the job? Actually, I know I will. I'm just being polite.
Who are you?
I am Nostradamus!
Wait, you're the Nostradamus?
No. I'm his nephew, Thomas.
Thomas Nostradamus.
I promise. Oh, but I share the same gifts as my esteemed uncle, and for half a crown, I can share those gifts with you. And for you, I see a new life with no teeth. That one was a freebie.
I think I'll keep looking if you don't mind.
Suit yourself, but beware the sign of the black dog.
Right, okay. Have a nice day, and good luck in the asylum. Half a crown, you say?
Excellent! So, what is it you wish the future to tell?
Well, you see, I'm a writer.
I knew that!
And I need to know, what will the next big thing in theater be? What audiences will be lining up to see.
Right, stand up! Give me some space! Yes. In the future, the theaters are very nice. Cushy red seats. And a roof! What is this?
What?
Oh, this is unbelievable!
What is it?
That much for a glass of wine?
What about what's on the stage?
Right, getting to that. Oh, what a spectacle! I have seen the future!
What is it?
The greatest, most magnificent thing in the theater will be... musicals!
Come again?
Musicals!
What the hell are musicals?
It appears to be a play where the dialogue stops. And the plot is conveyed through song.
Through song?
Yes.
Wait. So an actor is saying his lines, then out of nowhere, he just starts singing?
Yes.
Well, that is the stupidest thing that I have ever heard. You're doing a play, got something to say, so you sing it? It's absurd. Who on earth is going to sit there while an actor breaks into song? What possible thought can the audience think other than this is horribly wrong?
Remarkably, they won't think that.
Seriously? Why not?
Because it's a musical. A musical. And nothing's as amazing as a musical. With song and dance and sweet romance and happy endings happen in my house. Bright lights, stage fights, and the dazzling chorus. You wanna be great, then you gotta create a musical.
I don't know, I find it hard to believe that people would actually pay to see something like this.
Let's just say it's a Saturday night and you wanna go out on the town. Got a way to flatter who might give it up if you don't let her down. You can go see a tragedy, but that wouldn't be very fun. Or a play from Greek mythology. See a mother have sex with her son. You can go see a drama with all of that trauma and pain. Or go more relaxing and less taxing on the brain. Go see a musical, a musical. A popping piece releasing all your musicals. Where crooners croon a catchy tune. Remember they get ladies early until you swoon. Who's ours? Big applause.
What the hell are you doing now?
It's called a dance break. Apparently this happens
could be more amazing than a musical with song and dance and sweet romance? And with the musical, we might have half a chance.
Who's us? Big applause for them.
Simple minds from the one true book. Let's go.
Just let her go, Nigel. It'll never work out. And you know this big idea we've been looking for? Oh, I found it.
You have?
I want you to listen with an open mind because it's a bit radical, okay?
Okay. Well, what is it?
A musical. It's a play with songs that advance the plot and develop character as they seamlessly transition from dialogue into singing.
That is the most amazing idea.
Really?
It's brilliant, actually. How better to express the inner longings of the human soul than with music? And you're always writing songs on your lute.
Yeah, I already got it out and started banging out a few tunes already, and those poems you write, well, there's your lyrics. Wow, it's perfect for us.
Really? You think it's great?
Yeah, how did you come up with this?
Well, that's not important, but we need to think of what a musical should be about.
Oh, what?
Well, don't say your brother's from Cornwall.
Oh, well, I just think we should write something emotionally true. Something from the heart.
Really? Nigel, do you think the Bible was written from the heart?
Well, I would hope so.
Okay, you have a point there. But Matthew, Mark, Luke, they were all writing about something big, some event that was significant, and that's it! I got it!
You have?
Only the most significant historical event in the last 1,000 years!
What's that coming up the Silk Road? Out of China, the Black Death.
Plus, you said you needed help, so...
be. This just makes me
feel. Jeez, what is that? A bucket of crap?
Bear crap, to be precise. I've been promoted. This morning I didn't have a bucket.
Oh, jeez, no. Oh.
And plus, look, I'm even first penny. I'm gonna go put it in the money box.
Wait, no! I'll do that, dear.
Oi, bear crap boy.
Oh, hear that? I have a title. And one day, it'll be Bear Crap Woman. Keep writing. I love you, love.
Yep, love you too.
Oh, Nick, what are we gonna... God. Oh, good day, mistress.
The days were those when lit with love, till dusk of death did herald the eternal night.
Hey, I wrote that.
I know. I accidentally took this after our first encounter. Your sonnet, it's perfection.
Really? You thought it was good?
Yes, it touched me in places I didn't know could be touched. Forgive me, poems are forbidden in my household, especially poems of earthly love. Oh, is there no pity sitting in the clouds that sees into the bottom of my grief?
Romeo and Juliet, Act 3, Scene 5.
You've seen it?
6 times, and you?
8. If my father knew, he would disown me.
My brother, too.
I adore Shakespeare.
Me, too. I've got a Comedy of Errors, first edition.
I've got Sonnet number 1, signed.
Wow.
I know.
That's awesome.
I think you're his equal. If not better.
Oh, what? No way.
Oh, yes. Your sonnet has Shakespearean sophistication mixed with the complexity of Daniel Webster and the sensitivity of Samuel Daniel.
Wow. You really love poetry.
Oh, I do. I really, really do. I love Sidney and Marlowe, and often I borrow their words to express how I feel. I love poems of
want to show you something. I keep it hidden from my brother. It's a letter to me from the bard, saying he's received my sonnet.
You sent him a sonnet? And he's read it?
Well, he said he would.
You know him?
Kind of. He was in the same acting troupe as my brother. Oh, but I was just a kid then. It's not like he knows who I am or anything.
Master Nightbottom.
Yes?
An invitation from Master Shakespeare to be his personal guest at a recitation in the park.
Shakespeare? In the park? Can she be my plus one?
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way Stratford upon Avon, the king of poets, the sultan of sonnets, the man with the I am and I am a contaminant. Put your hands together for the one, the only, William Shakespeare! Thank you! Is it good to see me or what? Here's one for all you beautiful tutors out there. A little sonnet that's been very good to me. Let's see if you know it.
And she
consider reinvesting.
I'm not speaking to you. You ruined Romeo and Juliet. I'm off to see Richard II.
Oh, yeah? Richard can't find his horse, and then he dies!
No, no, no!
The next guy.
V, what are you doing? I thought I told you to cut this out.
Well, they needed good, strong men to haul the stage away. Why can't it be but good, strong women, huh?
Because some jobs are just better suited for men. Now give me that.
Okay.
Yes, Jesus. Okay.
You okay? Ooh.
Whoa. Are you okay?
Well, actually, I was going to tell you when you got home, but... do you know how I've been having these wild mood swings?
No.
Yes, you do! I told you about them! Well, anyways, there's a reason for it.
Oh, God, you've got the plague!
No, I'm pregnant!
You sure it's not the plague?
No! Isn't it wonderful?
It is. It's great news. It's okay. We're having a baby together.
Yeah. Isn't it wonderful?
It is.
Oh, Nick, you're finally going to be a father, just like you always wanted. Now we're gonna need that country cottage more than ever.
And I'm working on it.
And so am I. Get to it.
Well, no, no. You go home and rest, okay?
I love you.
I love you too. I'm gonna be a father. I'm gonna be a father.
Hello, Nick.
Shylock.
Are you gonna reconsider my offer now?
No, Shylock.
Why? Because you're prejudiced against the Jew.
Well, no, not me. All of Renaissance Europe. Besides, I've already got a Puritan on my back saying my writing's the work of Satan and I should burn in hell.
Don't listen to critics. They're facada. Come on, be a mensch. Let me help you.
I'm not that desperate.
Really? You have no show, no patron, and your brother's at a private party for William Shakespeare.
Wait, he's what? I'll kill him!
It's invitation only. But guess who has an invitation?
Nick doesn't want me to tell anyone.
Oh, God, he's so paranoid. Always has been, even when I was a lowly little actor.
You sad little truth.
Oh, he was always so insecure. And of course, with you as his partner, I see even more reason to be. I read your sonnets. Oh, it's good. It's quite good. I would like to see more. Is that your folio?
Oh, what? This is just a collection of random lines and thoughts.
Would you like me to give it a looky-loo? Oh, what am I talking about? Of course you would. I'm Shakespeare. All the world's a stage. Good line.
Don't worry. He's my plus one.
Trust me, I have no desire to stay. I'm just looking for my brother! Nigel, what the hell are you doing here? Hello, Will.
Hello, Nick. Been a long time.
Not long enough. What, is that my brother's notebook? Yeah, nice try. He was just offering to look at my ideas. Or his ideas, if they soon be known.
You dare bite your thumb at me, sir?
Quoting Romeo and Juliet, how pathetic.
By my troth, the tartness of his face doth sour the ripened grapes.
Oh yeah? Well, by my troth, your grape is stupid. Oh, jeez.
Such a clever retort, and you never wrote a hit. Oh, no, 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 no. We should actually be thanking him. Nick was the one who suggested I take up writing in the first place.
Because you're a terrible actor.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Take that back. Out of my way, Ethan. Where is she? Where's my Portia? You said she... You said you in your room reading your Bible. Hear me now, sinner. You dare cross me and corrupt my daughter? So help me God, I will smite these bottoms, and I will smite them hard. Come with me.
Portia, and you come with me. Let me go. I'm not a child. Then why are you acting like one? I told you to leave her alone, and now look what's happened. We're on the most wanted list of a deranged puritan. And Shakespeare almost got your notebook, which, by the way, is the only reason he invited you here. No! You're so naive, Nigel. You're lucky I was there. Trust me, I know every trick in his book.
Oh, it was all very confusing. And now she's gone, and I've lost my inspiration and the love of my life, and I've got to get it back, Portia!
No, Nigel!
So, ready to reconsider now?
You know what? Why the hell not? Let's do this!
Really? Mazel tov! I love it, I love it, I love it! So tell me, what's our new play about?
Well that's just the thing. We haven't come up with an idea yet.
Too bad you can't get a peek inside Shakespeare's notebook, huh?
You see, I've had a little trouble figuring out what a musical should be about.
Hair!
Hair?
Nah, that'd just be weird, wouldn't it? Little Shop of Horrors.
You know, that doesn't sound quite right either.
I know. Why is the shop so little?
I thought everything was bigger in Texas. Okay, look, the truth is, I'm kind of desperate, okay? And I need you to tell me, what will Shakespeare's greatest play be?
Are you sure you want to do that? Wouldn't you rather just come up with an idea on your own?
Well, I've tried and I can't, okay? I just can't. Maybe if I had a little more time and a little less pressure, but I just need one, just one, to get me out of this hole, okay? Just one.
I should warn you, for this, you will pay a great price.
I have every penny I've ever owned.
Not what I meant, but okay.
So, you're sure that this is gonna work? Because I've got a lot riding on this. Now I have a child, and...
Which I predicted. Remember? A new life with no teeth.
Oh, dang.
Stand back! Give me some space!
Paul.
I see it. Oh, I see it! Shakespeare's greatest play!
Yes?
The one they'll be talking about for generations to
yes.
come! And this play will be called Omelette!
Omelette?
Yes!
Like with eggs?
Yes! Wait! No, that's right, omelette! Oh, oh, what's this? Something, something, something Danish?
Like eating a Danish? So there's some sort of breakfast theme.
Ham something!
Ham omelette?
That must be it!
And you're sure that this will be a hit?
It might be known as the single greatest play ever written.
Yes!
Oh, oh, so many images. I'm getting a flood of visions.
Write them down, all of them.
I'll go get my quill.
Oh man, this is gonna solve so many issues. My future is suddenly looking brighter.
No more Mr. Anonymous. No more world that is Nick Bottomless. My name will be synonymous with being on the top. I can see it now. I'm the cat's meow. It's a hit.
Well, I have just written the thing that the critics are calling the greatest thing they've ever seen. The people are loving it. Can't
invited me to her castle where she knighted me. And privately, she told me that you're not any good, not any good, not any good, not any good. And she told me that all of your plays make her vomit, and nothing's as good as my musical vomit.
Wait. You wrote omelet?
Yes.
Well, I never thought that I would meet my equal, but I see I have been bested by the best. Maybe we could partner on a sequel.
Oh my, how the tide has turned. Let's review. What have we learned? See, you were here, but now we swap. So kiss this bottom, I'm on the top!
I am, little brother. So raise a glass to Omelet the Musical. Bottoms up!
Bottoms up! Yeah, this bottom's gonna be on top!
Thank you. Right, I think they missed him before. Like, when they were sitting at the dinner table.
Yeah, there was a couple that I was
thank you.
I got so many fans, so many demands, I can hardly go take a piss. Be in need of freak on the autographs, even they all want a piece of this. It's a cost that I pay, I'm like, jeez, I swear it's a burden, but I suffer through. It's all part of the game, the trappings of fame, but somebody's gotta do it. I know, I gotta go and get back to my bed and ink. What people just don't understand is that writing's demanding, it's mentally challenging, and it's a war. It's such a chore to sit in the room by yourself, oh my god, I just hate it. And you're trying to find an opening line or a brilliant idea, and you're facing the floor and looking for just a bit of divine intervention. That one little nugget, that one little spark, Eureka, you got it, you're ready to start. So now you can write, right, wrong, you're not even close, you remember that damn. Try a new word, but you hate the new word. And you need a new word, but you can't find the word. Where is it? What is it? What is it? Where is it? What is it? You know what you are? Please enlighten me. You're a petulant little boy and a fraud. Shut up, mother!
Sir.
Hello.
You asked for information on what Nicholas Body is writing.
Did he see me lose? Ah, oh, good. So he only saw me losing half of it. Speak, man. What news?
I've always thought of my day. You can't see Sarah before seeing Shakespeare in great play with me.
That sneaky little thief. Why doesn't he come up with his own ideas? It is, isn't it? It's really the worst.
To get it produced, and we'll call him a
Well, we haven't got a title for that yet. All right, everyone, let's get set. Take it from the top of the song. Watch and weep, Shakespeare. Watch and weep.
What's that cooking on your griddle? Whipped up and beaten.
My eternal love.
It's beautiful. This is what you should be
writing, words that feel true to you.
You mean other than omelet? I know, it doesn't feel right.
Then don't write it. Write words that feel true to you. It will move others as it has moved me.
Will it move your father? Change his mind? He doesn't approve of us.
Neither does your brother. Ooh, does that make us star-crossed?
Oh, wait, that's not a good thing. We both know how that story ends. With me drinking poison and you with a dagger in your heart.
Well, maybe it doesn't have to end that way. Maybe we can write a different story.
Starting to bore me. I'm thinking we
are. You dare defy me, daughter of Eve?
Please, Father.
I bid you grant your leave so you can pray forgiveness to the church. Instead, you slither up here to state your lustful desires, and I've lost my shirt.
Read your poem.
If love is a...
Silence! Henceforth, you will be locked in the church tower, and there you will stay until you're exiled to our brethren in Scotland.
No!
Portia!
Write what you feel, Nigel!
I will!
I love you!
And I love...
I'm warning you, boy. One more word and you will pay. Dearly.
Portia! Oh, what good is living when life is so cruel and my destiny is to be fortune's fool? If my pen be my one and my only companion, let it speak for my soul.
I better take these before this turns ugly.
Nick, just read it.
Okay, fine. Something happened last night. I promised to write what I feel, and here it is. Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
I love that. It's like a good line and good advice.
I don't know. I thought the whole breakfast thing was very strong. Everyone loves breakfast.
Exactly. But there's no ham, no eggs. You're completely ignoring the breakfast thing.
I'm ignoring the breakfast thing because it's ridiculous.
Oh, so my idea is ridiculous. But this whole true to yourself thing is right?
That's not just a lie, it's what I believe.
Well then you're foolish. You're a fool to think life is that simple.
I do!
Well, I don't.
Ugh, this is hopeless!
Just listen. It makes you a hopeless soul.
Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
To thine own self be true.
Where's the omelet?
Wow. What happened to you? Where's the brother who had integrity? Who inspired me to become a writer?
Well, he finally has a good idea, is all. An idea that is guaranteed to be known as the best play ever written.
How could you possibly know that?
I just do, okay? Now, we don't have time for this. We open in a week. So are you going to help me write Omelet or not?
No.
No?
I can't. It just doesn't feel right. And deep down, I don't think it feels right to you either.
Oh, well, it must be so great to be able to do whatever you feel, because you've had no one to care for but yourself. And that's why I don't want to write the sappy brother who carried you from Cornwall story, because I'm still carrying you, and I'm sick of it!
Then why don't I get off your back?
Nick, there you are! I've got news. Your new musical, Omelet, we're not selling tickets. Because we're sold out! They're lined up around the block.
What audiences will be lining up to see?
I told ya.
Okay, everyone, it's time. Do we want to do something meaningful and artistic? Or do we want to do something that will be a big hit and actually make some money? Then let's give the audience what they're hungry for. Omelet, the musical. Queens, and there and then you'll see the end. Well, justify me.
Oh, Portia, I did what you said.
I wrote from my heart. I wrote what I believed. I did everything. Oh, God. Look what happened. I don't know if I can ever work with my brother again.
Oh, Nigel! It's Will. Fancy meeting you here. So fairly and completely coincidental. Is that the Bottom Brothers' new play?
No, this is something I tried to write on my own.
May I?
Oh, sure.
I get it. No. No, it's just to be or not to be. What a piece of work, man, is. It's a lot of, cliches, Nigel.
Really?
Oh,
that's been done?
Yeah, of course. And as your friend, I will read through and see if I can salvage what I can. But I don't want to see your name on it. And your, musical omelet? I told everyone they simply must go and see it.
Really? But it's so
bold, daring. A lesser writer would shy away. Would you? Write your omelet. Not this or that. Forget this, write that.
Thank you.
poor yoke, I know thee well. There's something rotten, there's something rotten. You can smell it, you can tell there's something rotten. Now the kingdom is shot and it's all gone to pot. Heaven help us, there is something rotten. Frailty, thy name is Egg. How like thee I am, for I am what I am, and what I am doth be an illusion.
You get it, my lord.
Where is the cavity?
Angelical ball. He would not come.
Go and fetch him.
Alas, my lord, what vexes thee?
I dreamed a dream, Horatio, an impossible dream.
What be the meaning of it?
We've got trouble.
Trouble?
Trouble, I say. My father lies dead, and the serpent that did sting his life now wears his crown. Where is Macavity?
Macavity's gone.
Zounds!
My queen.
Oh, what a ball. I could have danced all night. Oh, gentle prince, thine absence was worrisome for the king and I.
If mama weren't married, twould not be so.
Where be the king?
Good fellow, what news?
The Nazis have arrived.
The Nazis?
Huzzah!
Ah, the Nazis are good people, one and all. With their succor, we shall wage war against the Puerto Ricans. Oh, luck be a lady tonight.
He wears the crown that should be on my head. Thou God, I hope I get it.
Fair guest, welcome. Bienvenue. Welcome. Fair guest, the wedding breakfast is now served.
My father knew me dead, and a funeral boiled eggs now coldly furnished forth the marriage table. Methinks another chef might have whisked our desperate eggs together as one.
Pray, nephew, what dost thou mean?
Well, I'll tell you. The fruit of life can't always taste like sweet persimmons. Sometimes it's hard to swallow, I'm afraid. But when life is handing you some lemons, then hand it back a mug of lemonade. My father said this to me, that he did, and then he blew me away with wisdom simple and concise. He said, Egbert, life is merely what you make of it. So heed this sound advice. You make wine from sour grapes. You got a flat pancake and call it a crepe. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet. You get coma from a nut. A dirty worm makes silk from out of his butt. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet. The There'd be a method to it. Simple truths.
Can I interrupt here? I have a question.
Fair Uncle Scar, why dost thou speakest when thou shouldn't speakest?
Because I want to know. How canst thou make an omelette when one of the eggs be rotten? Ah, therein lies the rub. The rotten one is you.
Toby?
Or not Toby?
Will?
That is the question.
You little snake.
And you said I was a crap actor.
You are not gonna make an ass out of me.
No need. You've done a fine job on your own.
Nick, what's going on?
Oh, allow me, since Master Bottom's plots are a little hard to follow. This man is a soothsayer who was hired by this man, who paid him to look into the future and steal my greatest idea. Even though I can't believe I come up with this shit.
Nick, is that true?
Guys, I can't explain.
You lied to me?
Nigel, you don't understand.
No, I don't.
My job here is done. Nice try, Nick.
Yeah, that just happened.
I failed. In every way.
I could have told you this was gonna happen, but you wouldn't have believed me.
No, you did tell me. You said there'd be a great price, and now I have to pay it.
And the provocative parading of eggs. And for such offenses, the law demands beheading.
Defendants, do you have a lawyer present?
No, Your Grace.
Correction! I am the lawyer. And they say beheading this man would be redundant, for the fool has clearly lost his head already.
Be
more specific. Masha. Did you steal all the money from the money box?
Yes.
Did you deceive your brother?
Yes.
Did you lie to your wife, who, by all accounts, is a loving and supportive woman? Write that down.
Yes, I did all of those things.
Well then, I enter a plea of temporary insanity. And before the sentencing is pronounced, I would just like to ask, what were you thinking?
The learned counselor is right. I did lose my mind. And worse, I lost myself. If only I had listened. A much wiser man than me tried to tell me. Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true. Why did I wander so far from the man that the two of you knew I could be? I lost sight of all that mattered somehow. I did not see it then, but I see it now. I just didn't think I had it in me, so I made it harder than it. send to you, to thine own self be true, to thine own self be true.
That's very touching, but the law demands beheading, and nothing can change that.
Words without thoughts never to heaven go.
I love how he puts his words in the wrong order.
But the quality of mercy is not strain. It droppeth like gentle rain from heaven above.
It's good because he entertains, but he makes you think as well.
But if a merciful ending is not written here today, then on my stage I shall replay all the events that happened here today. With all these characters and thee on thy bench, and then I shall see fair justice done.
Are you saying you might write a play about this with me as a character? Well, I wouldn't want to look the fool.
And you shot, Lord Falstaff. For if you see their lives spared and have these mischief makers banished, then seat him on this royal throne of kings, this blessed plot, this land, this realm, this England.
That's so much more elegant than beheading. I agree. Defendants, I sentence you to be banished, transported on the first ship for the New World, and take your so-called musicals with you.
Homosexuals, come back, charge them!
No, please, I'm a woman! I'm a woman!
You're welcome.
For what? All those lines are from my pages. You were just getting us out of the way so you could steal my work.
And beheading would have been way out of the way. But this world is better with you in it. Just not my world. And this amazing woman, impressive actor, persuading me to make a stand for free speech.
I'd say you've got about 20 free speeches there, Will.
Let it go, Nick. All's well that ends well.
Good line!
Look, stop giving him your best stuff.
All right. Good night, sweet prince, and a flight of angels. Do something. Exit Shakespeare!
Shakespeare!
Portia! I thought I'd never see you again.
Me too.
Portia, what are you doing here? I thought I sent you away.
And I'm going, but not before I say goodbye.
Very well. I will allow it.
It pains the heart to say adieu to someone you love, but alas, the time has come. Goodbye, Father.
What?
The good man's children will be prosperous in the wilderness. Psalms 112. You have your poets, and I will have mine.
What? No. Oh, damn it!
So, you made a deal with Shakespeare.
You wanted a new country home? We're getting a new home?
Didn't see that coming.
I hear that in the new world, a guy like me can be anything he wants.
And I bet they'll be open to something really original.
And brother, I know just the story we'll tell.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shylock Entertainment, in association with Pilgrim Productions, presents The Bottom Brothers and their touching life story.
Who's that coming out of Cornwall with his brother? Who's that starting out in London? Not each other. It's
They say it's his masterpiece.
What's it called? Hamlet.
Ah, Hamlet! I was this close.
Welcome to America.
Thank you for coming out and supporting live.